lessons online. All right, welcome back to our Human Geography chapter per se team 3.1. We're going to be moving on to part 10, okay, on your adaptation measures to climate change. So in the previous part, part 9, okay, I've already gone through what the mitigation measures are in trying to curb the effects of climate change, right? So this next part is just the second part, okay, of this two-part series, right? So if you have not checked it out, okay, I'll leave a link in the top right corner of the screen as well as in the description below, right? Go and check it out first because you need to first know what your mitigation measures are and why some of them may either be ineffective or may not be enough, okay, to actually curb the effects of climate change, hence the need to adapt to it. Alright, so let's just jump right into this video. Alright, so adaptation measures, okay, basically, what does this actually mean is to compromise and make the best out of current situation. So this is in a scenario whereby the effects of climate change has already taken place. So now we have to adapt, okay, to these effects and try and manage, okay, the impacts based on these adaptation strategies. So timely adaptation measures are required to avoid any potential adverse effects of climate change and to take advantage of the positive effects. So adaptation measures can help you to actually not only reap benefits, I mean, not only help you, okay, in adapting to the effects of climate change, but it can allow you to also reap certain benefits. Okay, we'll explore that later on. So adaptation refers to the process of adjustment to actual or expected changes in climate, as well as its effects. Okay, so it includes green and grey measures. So we are really looking at a case whereby you want to adjust, okay, your current processes or your current way of working, okay, to the actual effects of climate change that has already begun to take place. Alright, so we're not looking at a case whereby we're preventing, okay, no, we are no longer looking at preventing climate change from happening. We have accepted the fact that climate change has happened, and so now we will adapt to it and create new policies or new strategies that will help to fit, okay, the effects of climate change. So you've got green and grey measures, okay, they namely refer to projects such as infrastructure projects that incorporate nature and the environment as part of the solution. So it involves adaptation of the current situation, of course, and tweaks the environment to aid in preventing worsen impacts. So we'll look at some examples of this later on, but basically green and grey measures, okay, they basically incorporate nature into your solution. So by incorporating the environment, okay, trying to figure out ways how we can make use of the environment to our advantage instead, okay, to actually help us in this journey in adapting to climate change. Alright, so if you look at some examples, okay, you've got this thing called blue-green infrastructure. So this is basically the planned interconnected networks, okay, of natural and semi-natural areas, including water bodies, green open spaces that provide different ecosystem services. And then you've got green infrastructure. So this one is where when we're looking at natural and semi-natural areas, okay, with environmental features that are designed to manage, okay, to deliver different ecosystem services. And lastly is your grey infrastructure, right? So this one is we're looking at traditional human engineered measures, okay, we're looking at human-based strategies that perform infrastructure functions such as water and wastewater treatment plants or protective infrastructure such as dikes and seawalls. Okay, basically what these strategies are, okay, the different types of infrastructure measures, your blue, green, and grey measures, okay, they basically all aim target the different types of areas, okay, that are covered, okay, by not only nature but as well as by humans. Alright, so any sort of strategies or any sort of ways, okay, in which we can use natural facilities, natural infrastructure, as well as your human infrastructure, to try and incorporate cleaner and greener solutions into them to ensure that we can help to adapt to any sort of effects of this climate change that will affect these areas. All right. So what are the challenges to adaptation measures? Okay, we're always going to be looking at challenges of these strategies. So firstly, it's a lack of political commitment. So several countries may not see a need to actually implement such measures, okay, possibly due to the high cost and work involved and greater focus on other needs. There could also be insufficient cooperation. So there's a need for both your less developed countries and your developed countries to work together. For things like technological transfer, as well as knowledge transfer, okay, between the relevant stakeholders to aid in the process, and this may not be always available. And lastly, it's because of insufficient knowledge transfer and coordination. So there are no fixed plans here on adaptation measures as they really just come and go. New issues may arise and they may not have a direct solution, right? Adaptation measures really looks at that point in time, okay, what is the effect, okay, that has already happened as a result of climate change, and to try and create a new solution to actually adapt to it. So it may not always be so that there is a one strategy, okay, one adaptation strategy that fits everything, right? Different effects of climate change would warrant different types of strategies, okay? So that means there's going to be a lot of planning. Hence, there will be things like time lag, okay? You need to take time to plan what kind of adaptation measures to actually implement. And because largely, okay, a lot of countries tend to want to focus on mitigating climate change instead of trying to adapt to it, okay, they may not actually reap, okay, the most significant benefits. Alright, so what's the comparison of mitigation and adaptation strategies? So the first key difference is going to be cost. Okay, mitigation involves immediate cost to implement the preventive strategies, while adaptation only involves cost when the effects have actually set in. Alright, so mitigation, we're planning ahead, so it's usually going to involve a much higher cost, and we are still unsure, okay, whether that solution may even be effective, okay, in actually curbing the effects of climate change. Hence, it actually involves very, very immediate costs. Okay, as compared to adaptation, whereby once the effects have taken place, then we try and adapt and spend money on adapting to it, okay, to creating a new solution. Okay, they also differ on scale. So mitigation operates on a variety of scales, from community to national to global, while adaptation measures have to address that specific effect of climate change at that specific area. Okay, for instance, if there is a sudden rise in a river level, okay, and then the river banks or the river channel starts to overflow, right? There is a need to address only that specific river. Okay, not that does not mean that every single river has actually experienced this overflowing. Okay, it could only be just this one. Hence, you can just need to adapt, okay, to the effects of climate change that has affected this river channel. Alright, so it really looks at the specific area in which has been affected by a certain effect of climate change. So not every single area will require adaptation. Okay, a lot of them, if they're well mitigated, can definitely prevent any sort of adaptive strategies from being implemented. So the overall evaluation, okay, is basically that you need to complement, okay, mitigation and adaptation strategies so as to enhance effectiveness in dealing with climate change. Okay, this one is without a doubt. Okay, always go for that two-pronged approach. Mitigation allows you to first prevent the possible effects of climate change from happening, and then adaptation allows you to actually, if your mitigation fails, then you can actually help to use adaptation strategies to help you adapt better to the effects that has already happened that you cannot control. So if proper mitigation strategies are set in place, there will definitely be less of a chance to even adopt, okay, adaptation strategies, as the effects of climate change will be better managed. Okay, definitely if your mitigation policies are set in place, for instance, let's say if you're looking at the same river channel, okay, you already have barricades, or you already have some sort of upstream flood control that will help you to prevent the flooding to occur, then chances are you don't even need to adapt, okay, to the river even overflowing in the first place. Alright, so mitigation strategies aims to reduce the magnitude of the effects of global warming and increases the time or prevents the need for adaptation strategies, right? Like I've just mentioned. So when we come down to our exam requirements, okay, explain, you just need to really explain the adaptation measures with relevant examples and the purpose it serves. So this one, just go and do a bit of research, okay, on what your green and gray measures are. And then after that, it tends to come out for larger mark essays, okay, alongside mitigation strategies. So like I've said, okay, this topic banks a lot on mitigation. Okay, end of the day, when you're writing an essay, the bulk of your essay is obviously going to be on mitigation, because firstly, effects of climate change, not the full effects, have actually set in place in today's world. And not only that, is that we always want to try our best, okay, to always, the saying goes, right, prevention is better than cure. We always want to try and prevent climate change from happening first, before we even see a need to even adapt to it. Alright, so adaptation always comes as a secondary factor. So as far as possible, adaptation should not be the main focus of an essay on climate change, but instead, it should be to mitigate, okay, the effects. And if that fails, if all else fails, then we will rely on our adaptation strategies. Alright, so that is basically what this whole part on adaptation measures are. So if you have any questions, okay, you can always leave it in the comment section below. I will answer them. If not, if you did enjoy this video, you learned something, okay, be sure to give it a like, as well as subscribe to the channel. It does help me out a lot, and it's free. It doesn't cost you anything. Alright, so if not, that is all I have for this video. Okay, I will see you guys in the next one. Keep studying hard and have a good one. Bye-bye.